Portfolios as a freelancer, let's talk about them. Let's talk about why they're so important. Let's talk about the structure that your portfolio should have. And then I'll walk you through my Notion template for a portfolio. And you can grab it for free, of course, in the description box below. All right, let's dive into it. Hey, my name is Daya, freelancer, digital business manager, most recently entrepreneur. And as always, you can find sections on the play bar below. If you want to skip to a certain part of the video, your time is precious, so take what you need. And if you want to watch this on 2x or 1.5x or 1.75x, please feel free to do so. I will not be offended in the least. Okay, let's dive in. All right, first up, why are portfolios so important as a freelancer? The first and most important reason is you need to have something to prove to clients that you know how to do what you say you know how to do, and to have something to show them and be like, check it out. This is actual proof that I can do this exact same thing, but for you. So it's really the biggest form of proof that you can give clients to your services and your skill set. The second thing is it can really show clients your style and your way of doing things. So not just can you put together a project plan or can you put together a branding guide? Can you put together a blog post? But it's your way of writing, your way of designing, your way of processing information, your way of creating systems. All of that stuff can be a really great way for a client to decide, is this person a good fit for what I really want and what I'm after? It can also give them clarity on what you do, how you do it, your process, the end deliverable that they will be getting through working with you. It can help them get to know you as a person and as a freelancer. And also, of course, it bridges that gap between them not knowing who you are, what you do, no trust factor with you, to somebody where they're like, okay, I feel like there is a bit of trust. I can see that they've done this before. Let me give them my money. Okay, so that's why portfolio is essential. I recommend it to every single freelancer, no matter what skills, no matter what services you offer, you should have a portfolio. In my course, DBM Bootcamp, I train digital business managers. And even as digital business managers, where you may be thinking, I'm not sure what a portfolio item could be because it's not a very visual job when you do project team and ops management, we still create portfolio samples and we still have portfolios. And that is what makes you stand out when you apply to things and a client gets 50 applications and three of them have outstanding portfolios. So no matter what you want to offer, no matter what service you want to offer as a freelancer, you have to create a portfolio. All right, let's dive into this template and I'll walk you through what I normally recommend for a portfolio structure. This is a relatively simple structure. You can definitely get more complicated and fancy if you want, but I figure you're here to get something really fast and just like run with it. And what is important to remember for each section, so kind of priorities to remember. All right, so the first thing that I will recommend is having your super brief intro. This is kind of like the TLDR section of your portfolio. You really want to make a strong impression, but more importantly, you want to have a very clear, strong impression. So not just, whoa, like this person's telling me something. You want it to be, whoa, okay, I understand 100% what this person does and who they do it for. And I always recommend doing this in the form of an I help statement. So that goes, I help, insert target audience, do, what do you do? What are your services? What are your skills? So that they can, what do they want? What does the target audience want above everything else, right? So that's the first most important thing. I think if you really hone in on your I help statement, make it really specific as much as possible. Make it very, very clear. You can really run with that sentence anywhere. You can do that in an elevator pitch. You can do that when you're at networking events. You can put it on your portfolio. You can say it on discovery calls. That will not only give that person clarity, it also gives you clarity on what you offer and who you ideally should and want to be working with. All right, so an example could be, I help busy female entrepreneurs with their project and team management so that they can finally take a vacation and know that their business is in really good hands. You know, that's just a rough on the spot example from my brain who's processing at about 50% right now, but you can kind of see that automatically I can tell as a client, okay, am I a good fit? Am I a female entrepreneur? Am I a busy female entrepreneur? You know, do I want to take a vacation? Do I want to give up something like project and team management so that I can actually check out of my business and know that it's in good hands? And if those two boxes are ticked, then this person might be a good fit to work with. So I really recommend taking your time and creating that I help statement, really working on it, really thinking through what are the pain points that I address for this client? What do they truly want? What they truly want is not your service. What they truly want is what your service will unlock for them in their business, more money, more time back, more energy back, more efficiency, more joy in their work, like whatever that is, you need to find that and that very specific thing and use that in your I help statement. And yes, be specific, like be specific. Sometimes I see people like they say a lot about what they do, but at the end of it, I'm still not clear what exactly it is they do. You know, like for example, I hear a lot of like, I help entrepreneurs with mindset so that they can have clarity. Like, those are all technically, they might technically exactly describe what you do, but that's not really specific enough to be memorable or powerful to your person. So as much as you can, try to get specific. Obviously, you don't need to get super specific, but try to get a little bit specific. You do want to weed out people that would not be a good fit for your services in that process. So be specific whenever you can. And if you want, you can post it below in the comments and I would love to help you craft your I help statement. And in this intro section, I also recommend having two call to actions, one or two, maximum two. Don't give them too many options for things to the next steps. If there are too many options, they might be distracted, they might be overwhelmed, they might not know what to click. So just give them two easy options. Here, I just gave them email me. Basically, if you have a question, if you want to chat something before we hop on a call, please email me. And the second thing is book a free call with me. That's normally the first step of my client funnel. So, you know, book a free call. We can discuss your business. We can discuss if we're a good fit. And then we can talk about like a proposal, invoice, contract, that kind of stuff. So give them some easy call to actions or contact information there. All right, the next section right here is kind of the what. So what exactly do you do? Again, most important thing here is clarity. Do not put too much random stuff that doesn't seem to go together. It's really confusing if on your portfolio you put like, I do copywriting, I offer yoga lessons, I do dog training, and also I do email and calendar management. Like it's too much, and I think it really dilutes the impact of your services, and it makes you look potentially less credible because you lack focus and you're not really a focused expert in one thing. And it's possible you're an expert in all four of those things, but because they don't connect to each other, a client might be wondering, you know, do they actually know how to do all of these things? Like, do they know how to do them well, or are they kind of like doing them all side by side, which means they're probably not as focused or skilled as somebody who's only focused on copywriting, for example. If you truly want to offer like seriously different services, I would recommend making separate portfolios so that you have focus portfolios for like graphic design, focus portfolio for copywriting, so that you have that to send to the client that it would be applicable for. So in this section, really, you can just edit it. So call the service, for example, I might type in like project management, and then I would just bold this, and then I would do a 1-2 sentence description of what exactly the service is. And very important, not just what it is, but why they should care. So the biggest trick I always do is I write like, okay, project management, I can help you plan your projects and babysit them from beginning to end to ensure that the project goes well. And then add the words, so that you can ... because that will allow you to unlock why they should want this service, right? So they might be thinking, yeah, project management, I guess it's interesting to have somebody plan their projects, but so that you can not worry that a project is going to get done, or not worry that all of your ideas are going to sit in your idea bank forever and not actually happen and not be put out into the world. You know, figure out what the pain point is and what they ultimately want through your service. Your service is kind of like the vehicle to where they want to go, and figure out where they want to go and put that into the brief description. That's a really good way to sell your service in a way that's tied to the client and what they want. Yeah, the most important thing here is give them clarity. All right, the next section is when we get to the portfolio, the real portfolio part. It's examples of things that you have done. So real concrete examples. My big tip here is don't give too much away. Sometimes I see people kind of like creating this like step-by-step how-to of how I did this project. It's like veering into case study area. And I think case studies are amazing, but you have to be very careful with case studies that you do still protect your process, your framework a little bit. So it's not just you're teaching them how to do what you do, right? That you're more so focused on showing them a trailer or a teaser. You're not showing them the whole movie. That's, I think, the distinction is like, when you're creating case studies, when you're creating samples for your portfolio, how can you show them the coolest parts, kind of the outcome, kind of the end why? You kind of want to show them like all the cool explosion scenes and the dramatic scenes, but you don't want to walk them through the entire movie of what's going to happen, because then chances are they're not going to buy the movie. If your work is visual, like you're a graphic designer, share some kind of visual, of course, you know, branding, logos, website design, very, very visual things. If it's not visual, that's okay. Like sometimes people come to me and they're like, oh, damn, my thing is not very visual. What should I put in my portfolio? You can break down what happened via text in the card, essentially like a mini case study, or you can record a little walkthrough like video, Loom, you can use Loom or Vimeo video. Showing them what the output was. And that can be a really great way, because then they can hear your voice and they're starting to build that trust level with you more so than just reading what you did. If you are recording a walkthrough video, make sure to keep it short. I recommend less than a minute because business owners are very, very busy, so they're not going to watch a 20-minute video walking through one of your projects. So try to keep it at least 1 minute so they're kind of like wanting more. All right, so in the project samples, I created a little mini template if you want to do a text version of these mini case studies. But essentially at the top, you'll have about the project. So write roughly what the project was, you know, give them some context, give them the initial state of where you were and the goal of the project. So what did the client want? What was the intended aim? And this can be a really good focus to share in this section because sometimes clients will say, oh, that's my goal too, right? If you write something like the goal of the project was to increase their email list by 20% in the coming 6 months, a client might be thinking, oh, that's also my goal. So let me pay attention to this project because they could potentially do the same thing for me. The next two sections are optional. You can remove them if you want, just gives them a little bit more detail. So sharing a little bit of your process. So like give them transparency into how you work with clients. How do you make sure that they are taken care of? How do you make sure that you are checking in with them? How do you make sure that your framework is unique compared to your competitors, right? What are things that you do that your competitors do not do? But again, don't give them a step-by-step. Just give them kind of the highlights, but not so much the detailed how-to. Then deliverables, so what did you deliver at the end? And then results. Results are kind of the most important section here. You wanna share cool results, things that happened. Did they grow their email list by 20%? You know, what other cool indirect things happen as a result of this project, that kind of stuff. And then of course, a client testimonial is always really great for social proof to show like, hey, the client actually loved the results and they loved working with us and that entire process and we have great soft skills kind of thing. So yeah, this is a rough template you can follow. You can also do this video wise, and with Notion, you can easily embed a video. So you can just plus, and you can go down to video and then you can embed an unlisted YouTube video or a Vimeo video here if you would like. And then I would normally screenshot the video and then add that as the cover, and then it will pop up here and then it'll look really professional and cool. And they'll be like, ooh, what's this project? And they'll click on it and they'll be able to watch the video and all that good stuff. Cool. So that is that section. Now, very important. If you're thinking to yourself, Daya, I don't have any samples to add into your portfolio. Make some. I made portfolio samples when I first began as well, because I really just did not have anything. When I first began, I was doing some like graphic design stuff. So literally what I did was I found images on Google, I downloaded them, and then I Photoshopped things out of the background and I made those my samples. You can do that, right? Like for a copywriter, you can write up copy for a pretend sample landing page. For a graphic designer, it's very easy, create fake graphics for a fake brand. For a digital business manager, you can put together a little mini system for things that you know your potential clients really, really want a system for. Like in DBM Bootcamp, we ask students to do exercises where they put together sample project plans, communication plans, hiring systems, testimonial trackers, simple CRMs to show clients like, hey, I know what I'm doing. Check out this cool thing that I created that I could easily do for you kind of thing. For a virtual assistant who wants to offer Instagram management, you can put together a sample grid and graphics. You can write up some caption templates as well, just to show them like, hey, I'm really awesome at this. Really, essentially what you want to do is you want to take the service that you offer and create a mini sample size version. Like kind of like, if you know, like there's like full bottle perfume, like sample perfume, you want to give them the sample perfume so they smell it and they're like, this is awesome. Now I want the full size kind of thing. In this section, I would recommend sticking to 3 to 5 portfolio samples and really go for quality over quantity. Really take your time, make sure that these are the best things that you can show, because business owners are busy, right? They don't have time to look through 30 different portfolio items. So really make sure you're putting your best foot forward, showing them the great stuff, because if your great stuff is at the bottom, they might not even see it. So it's better to just give them like, hey, check out these 3 amazing, incredible things we did. And they know that they just have to look at those 3 and they can get a good idea of what you do and how you do it. Finally, let's go down. This is the who section. The who are you section needs to be succinct. So don't share your life story. Keep it very, very short, simple. It has to be, most importantly, client-centric. So it needs to be about the client, why they should work with you, what are your expertise and experience levels that are relevant to what the client is looking for. That's very important. And what you do, again, simplicity, clarity, super, super important. And another really important question that needs to be answered in this section is why you, right? So this is your chance to establish credibility and authority in your service, in your skill set, why you are the best person for this. And if you can, use numbers and pull out really concrete experience, things that you have, metrics, anything that a client would be like, whoa, that's really cool. Numbers are always more memorable. So whenever you can, share numbers. You know, I help a client grow her website traffic by 20% in 20 months. I got stuck on 20. I helped a client launch a project that did $300,000 in 6 months. You know, share numbers because that is the best form of credibility and authority you can build possibly as a freelancer. And then yeah, testimonials, add them here, make them nice. Please replace this picture of me with your picture, and please replace these pictures with your clients' headshots, obviously. You can also include some frequently asked questions here at the bottom if there are frequently asked questions you get about your service, about how you work with clients, about your packages, anything like that. You can just add the question here. And if you toggle it open, you can type in the response here. And then the last and arguably most important step is the next step section. So this is the call to action. This is the what should they do now. Sometimes I see portfolios that just end and they don't give them direction on what the next step is to work with this person. So it's really important that you have some sort of a call to action. I recommend having no more than two. You don't want people to get overwhelmed or distracted. So I always do something like, if you have questions, comments, concerns about anything, please email me. I'm more than happy to answer that. If you want to tell me about your business and see if we'd be a fit to work together, then book a call, because booking a call is the best way to enter a client, to have a client enter your client funnel, definitely. So hopefully that portfolio walkthrough is helpful. You can find the link to the portfolio template below, or you can get started making your own in Notion just following the structure that we talked about in this video. If you have got cues or tips on portfolios, please let us know in the sharing comment circle below so we can all benefit from your infinite wisdom. As always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Okay, bye.